What's up, guys? My name is Alex Barham, and last week I did a video for you on my updates to this RPM that I'm going to be reviewing in the outfitting just to increase comfort. And this weekend I spent 3.5 hours in it doing 17 miles of remote wilderness on the Hudson, and I have to say I'm limping, I'm miserable. It was not as comfortable as I wanted it to be. So this is the kit I went in there with. And I wound up bringing one of these along and tossing it in. That's the underseat pad from a Contour kit. And while it helped a lot, still not quite there. So I'm gonna tear into this and do a little bit of diagnosing and see if we can figure out what caused my legs to lock up and why 1 hour was cool, but 3.5 was not. So for starters, by pulling out the smaller screw in front of the seat bolt, you get this entire thigh hook plate. So both thigh hooks are incorporated into one, and I noticed on mine there is an A labeled in. I've heard a rumor that one set had the legs going basically straight and the other gave you more of a modern knee bend. This is a modern Contour thigh hook, and what I can do is, using the slot on the back side in that screw hole I already showed you, simply toss this in and dry fit it. And when I did that, that was the immediate cure to all my ergonomic issues. I already did one video on how to update this, so I'll drop a link up here. Let's skip ahead and see how much further I've gotten. Now, for a moment in the life of Alex, I somehow left the shop with two of the exact same ones. So I'm gonna have to go scavenge a right-hand one out of a perfectly good boat. Here at Mountain Man, we use only the finest in form-fitting technology. And the magic spot is right there, where the light shines through. Already hate myself for not doing this with an Allen bolt. There we are. I can't believe I just made this thing awesome and I already have to pull it apart. Ugh. Well, turns out the other right side to match that one is in Canada. So we're gonna make the one from Mr. Clean work and worry about it later. Quick look at comparison. You can see how straight one of my legs to be and how far forward the original was. Here is outfitting version 3.0. So now my legs go all the way into the corner pocket and then forward. I had a really good time paddling this boat, but this has turned into a project. I'm hoping that by the time I've got this review done, what I will be saying is to start here instead of ending here, because this is so far the biggest difference I've seen, but woof. Last thing I learned tonight is that the foot block system that I stole out of another Contour boat, which I was hoping I could retrofit in, not gonna work. This, I believe, is from a small Nomad, and it's definitely too wide and too tall. And the biggest issue I have is that this piece, which rides across the bottom here, is not gonna work with the center bar system that's inside the RPM. So what you could do is you could unbolt this and then bolt it into the RPM stock front block, and that would give you the sliding plates and the easy adaptability into the foam block system that comes with it. That's really nice and adjustable, and that wouldn't be too hard at all. But in terms of just a wax on, wax off, it'll require a little bit more work. So I know I said I didn't want to install a Contour outfitting kit, but last night when I was putting this boat away, I realized really just how much gap there is between these old school seats and the hull, and it rocking back and forth an inch all the time. And the way I abuse boats is going to cause oil canning. And this thing's way too cool to just let that happen. So I'm gonna go all in, and you know, long term, either I keep this boat or I auction it off and raise money for AW, but either way, it'll add something to it. Let's take a quick look at the old seat versus the new seat. So this is the old school, thin, one layer of plastic, sits super low, no adjustments up here whatsoever. There's only one drill hole. By comparison, the Contour is, yes, a tiny bit heavier, but everything here is rigid and solid, and I could, you know, just smash this off of stuff as long as I wanted, and it won't deform, it won't change, and it's definitely more comfortable. So, measured everything up. Looks like it all holds all the same measurements, which is fantastic, and now it's just time to drop it in. Huh. Well, I guess that explains why I couldn't get my drain plug to do much of anything. It's breathing through a straw. The major functional difference for getting this seat back in is going to be that I'm going to have to notch on both sides the foam block to get it in. The old seat basically laid flat against the hull and these just slid over. This new one is going to sit up like that much in the front and like, yeah, a little more in the back. So I'm just going to have to kind of eyeball and notch and measure and then hammer it home. I have to say that did not take a lot of effort. Drops right in, screw holes are lining up, and I'm just going to test fit it now before I go any further, make sure I actually like the height and that I can get it back as far as I want it and still be within the specs of the seat and the hole. Super easy. Pro tip. Make sure there aren't double pads inside the seat. I totally forgot this came out of my friend Sarah's boat and she likes to sit really high. So I've got the seat bolt in, and right where you can see that light moving, that is my flashlight showing me where the seat track is. So, like I was saying at the end of my last video, I could just bolt this up right now and call it a day, but the best thing for me to do is take the extra little bit of time, use the hardware that came with this boat, and drill out a second hole, switch it to a two bolt seat system, which will make this much stronger in the long run. Let's do it. This is why I use a template. You can see the light I used to make my mark, slide out of the way, straight through the slot. Everything is perfect. Notched out the front block, excellent fit. So now all we have to do is do the same thing on the back. And basically what it comes down to is figuring out what this height is, looking straight down from the back of the cockpit rim, because usually there's some sort of mark or indent that you can use to eyeball, and then measuring out that height by that distance back and just cutting out whatever's there. Back one also slipped in beautiful, just with that eyeball method. Now, I've thought a couple times about just cutting this curve out, and I actually marked it to just go ahead and do it, but it is actually giving me a lot more rigidity in that pillar and how it locks in. I can always cut it out later. So similar to how I had this before, what I want to do is run a dual rope system, so I have an attachment on my back band top and bottom. So I'm thinking drill a hole here in the back, hole here in the back, and one big one up here, and everything will feed through to the ratchet that way. In these low height boats, that just really helps the back band from over rotating forward or rotating backward, and the nice smooth even pull I just find really nice. Right, in the boat, super, super comfy, huge improvement. I'm even a little further back, which I discovered wasn't even an option in the first one, liking it. crazy thing that I was wondering about and turned out to be true was I actually need hip shims now because the other seat came in so far to the inside. I'm gonna have to go find hip pads. Go figure. Somehow I only had one nice Wave Sport hip pad, so I'm rocking these OG the fluid ones, but that'll change momentarily. And this is a lot better. I'm actually super excited to paddle it, and I'm guessing when I'm done this will probably pop up for sale, and we'll raise some money for AW. So the logical question is, you know, is it really worth ripping this seat out? And check this out. Definitely.